for getting on. So welcome to Attack It Adventures today. Today we're here to watch paratroopers drop over seven lakes in North Carolina. So keep on watching and go attack the day in your neighborhood.
One over here, and you get a better angle at him. I'll make sure you don't fall in.
Okay.
I'll do my best.
If I do, oh well.
Okay, I'll see
four. There's at least six.
1, 2, 3. Okay. Wow. And there are six.
One way up. Yep, there are six there.
And they're going to, how
they're going to land right in here.
It's called, they know how to maneuver.
Right, they're
steerable. They're steerable, yeah. I think Bill jumped with those.
Really?
Yeah, he jumped with the first. He was.
I don't know. Jump with first.
Oh, you only jumped with. Okay, I
Ronnie,
wasn't sure if the last one you did.
Ronnie, come on.
Yeah. Oh, look at that. That is so cool. I see five. Woo-hoo. Oh, yeah, there's six. I see. 2, 4, 6. Yeah,
six of them.
Okay. That one on the bottom was kind of in the clouds.
Woo!
Oh, wow.
Wow. That and then how do they get out of the water?
They'll have a boat that'll take them. Yes.
Well, I hope so. Bob's going out and pick them up. Okay.
I thought I had to catch them all before they even hit the water.
See, a little zigging and zagging.
And then the helicopters will be up at the community center after. And lunch. See you later.
You don't have his brake. You slow down. I can't stop.
I'm going to stop in the air, but they're still coming this way.
My brother will be the first kid from the world.
Come on over.
Oh, wow. Because sometimes the guy is just freeze the cool. You know what he did? Exactly.
Okay. That's funny.
Somebody said they were going to go into the water and then dive and then swim where you go.
Five to six.
Bacon soda.
400, so they're right about where they want to be.
There we go.
Oh my gosh. Those are different parachutes, huh?
Oh yeah, those are standard.
I wish they would jump with the flag, you know? I wonder if they'll do that today at all. Like what they do in Southern Pines for Veterans Day. Those are steerables.
They're going to do 10 of 6, huh?
Six, yeah. So here go back.
You'll go back to the community center, pick up the next one?
Yes, ma'am.
And these are they'll end up out here where the other guys were.
Yeah, they have a hard time steering.
Yeah, they kind of have, yeah.
This is so exciting.
It is.
It's an event.
I'm sure it isn't when they're doing it for real.
Yeah. It's always exciting.
Is it?
Yeah.
Or they wouldn't be doing it.
You
get paid.
Oh. Do you ever watch that?
Really?
Oh, really? I watched every episode.
It was crazy.
See, the wind's blowing from behind us.
Oh, it is.
These guys are pretty close, though.
Yeah, they are.
You have about a second to follow the last jump or something. They will.
That's like Cheryl was just down. She was so tiny. She
stayed up for 10 minutes.
Bill had she worked with someone and she tried to, she got her to sit up and she ended up sitting there. She just was like this. Yeah, she was so tiny.
Yeah, put weights on, right?
Let's see.
Resign. But that lot is so.
Did the streamer drop? There goes the streamer right there. It just fell right there where those people were.
Oh, look at the size of the guys. Yeah, that's a big bass.
It's time to go fishing.
That's an exciting one. Yeah, I saw him swimming underneath the dock as I was talking.
Thank you. they were separated from their drop. The ship, the boat's going to go get them. Yeah, I seen that. Here's some more coming up. They're still picking up the guy, the first round out there, the guys. Eventually, we should be seeing them right about coming out of that cloud. There we go. Woo! Woo! One loner out there. Why is, I'm about to say, why are the waves choppy? Here. Thank you. girl. I missed that on the video. Big wave is coming at me. Goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Just like to jump the big old helicopter, just walk out the back. You know, drop the rack on the back.
Yeah. Nice day to jump out of an airplane or a helicopter. You You hear people clapping and the waves hitting.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
rest of the afternoon. All the military families are welcome to use our amenities here. Our basketball court, our tennis court, our pool, we enjoy ourselves. Thanks again. And at this point, I'd like to introduce Colonel Mott to say a few words. Through the legwork, came out, did the survey with help with y'all, And then they posed the question, well, sir, what do we call the crowdsourcing? I said, that's a great question. I don't know what we call the crowdsourcing. I said, why don't we leave it up to the community? And so obviously the community chose Mr. Ray Lambert. And I can tell you, after reading his bio and what you just heard, being on the first wave of three invasions, that is awesome. We go out goes through all that, then it comes to the school, and where's the sculpture going to be? And so if they have to handle that, plan on that also. This is not necessarily in the bottom of our sculpture, the young sculpture, I was in the regular country, and just one day I jumped a piece, and they were down there in Iraq, and consumed this piece by Michelle, and General Walker by Eddie, asked me to go to lunch for them one day. So we went to lunch, and we were talking, and all they talked about was how happy they were, how unhappy they were. They really don't have a home. They'll be talking about the nice furniture she had in the story for a long, long time, and that they don't can't live the way we live. And so that's the way our militaries are. And these women that go through all this, give so much, and it's just hard, hard. I know it is. Military is still hard. They're the heroes. Without their support, our military would not be what it is today. So let's give them all a little bit. I've met some of these soldiers here, these nice guys, these young guys. I have grandchildren over there. So that was General Gavin. And then you got it from Lieutenant Jane Gavin. So we fought in Parker, the Air Force, the 1st Division, and many other divisions too. But we always seemed to end up supporting each other and working together. So I'm very proud of our service. I hope today to be more involved with you guys at Fort Bragg, like I am, and still involved at Fort Riley. I've worked with the 32nd Brigade. I've been to France.